Hello children, so today we are going to see the continuation of the chapter Principles of Inheritance and Variation. So today we are going to cover polygenic inheritance and pleiotropy. Here the polygenic inheritance, when one character it is now controlled by more than one gene, you call that as polygenic inheritance. So here for example, when you see the human beings, you cannot see like pea plant exactly tall or dwarf or short like that. You cannot see. You can see the variation of height. The same way when you observe the color in the case of human being, you can see variation of colors. There is no only dark or only fairer color. You can see variation of skin color. So why it is like that? The various range of color, various range of height you can see in human beings. So why is it like that? So because that feature, it is controlled by three or more genes. So when it is like that, you call that as polygenic trait. There are multiple genes are involved in polygenic inheritance. So apart from the gene, the environment also play role. For example, you may be having fairer skin color, but if you are roaming in sunlight, you may become dark also. So why is it like that? Because apart from the gene, the environment also playing the role. When you see the tall gene, if you are having the tall gene, but anyhow, if you don't eat nutritive food, you may be short also. Once again, the environment, that is the nutrition, so that is the nutrient, whatever you take, that is controlling your height also. So let us see detailly by taking the example skin color. So here the skin color is controlled by three genes, capital A, capital B, capital C. When all are capital letter, the people will be having darker skin color. So that is in double dose, capital A, capital A, capital B, capital B, capital C, capital C. Then they will be having the darkest skin color. When the genotype with recessive alleles, small a, small a, small b, small b, small c, small c, when all are of small letter, they will be having lightest skin color. Means according to the amount of gene present, quantity of the gene present, whether more capital letter gene, that is the dominant genes are there, the people will be having more darker color, and more recessive alleles are there, the people will be having the lightest skin color. Means the quantity of the genes, no, they are controlling the feature. So that's why you can call this as quantitative inheritance also. Here, just you see the diagram, polygenic inheritance. So when you see here, you can see the variation of colors. When you see the second diagram Punnett square, whatever they have given here, you can see the capital A, capital B, capital C. When they mix up in the corner, there is all six genes are of six, all are of capital letters. So then they will be having the darkest skin color. You can see the extreme corner, that is zero what they have given. So here, what is zero? So why? Because all are of small letter. So when capital small a, small a, small b, small c, when all are of small letters, then the people will be having the lightest skin color. Actually, when the darker the gene is present, so they will be making you to promote the formation of more melanin pigment. When more melanin pigments are there, automatically people will be darker. When less melanin pigment, otherwise no melanin pigment is there, people will be fairer in color. So you can see the range. Actually, the number 6 it is given means all are of dominant. So here when you see 0 means nothing, no dominant gene is present. So accordingly the number is given here, 5 means 5 dominant genes are present, 4 means 4 dominant genes are there, 3 means 3 dominant genes, 2 means 2 dominant genes are there. So accordingly the presence of the dominant gene means the quantity of the gene determines the type of color. Here also they given the bar diagram, you can see here, according to the means the amount of genes present, they are putting in the bar diagram. There you can see the amount of means the people, the number of people having the darker and the lighter skin. So here the quantity of the gene, it is determining the type of skin color. The same is applicable to human height also. Next is pleiotropy. So here when you see a pleiotropy, when a single gene exhibit multiple phenotypic expression, already we seen in the case of pea plant, pea also it was exhibiting the pleiotropic effect. The shape of the seed and the starch synthesis, it was controlled the same way. So here in human being, when you see that pleiotropy, you know, one phenylketonuria is one disease is there, that is very good example for pleiotropy. So here actually the disease is caused due to the mutation in the gene which is coding the enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. Means phenylalanine hydroxylase will be produced in the presence of a particular gene, and that gene is mutated. As the gene is not there, the people, they are not able to produce the particular enzyme. So when the enzyme is not there, the metabolism will be affected. When the metabolism is affected, the phenotypic expression, various type of phenotypic expression is produced in human beings. So they may be mentally retarded, and the body hair will be reduced, and the skin pigmentation will be reduced like that. No, they will be showing the various phenotypic expression. So as a single gene is controlling so more than one phenotypic expression, that you call that as pleiotropy. So phenylketonuria is a disease in human being. That's a good example of pleiotropy. It is one type of, it is caused due to mutation. Okay, children. So thank you. So today we have covered regarding these two. You study this, then let us meet in the next class.